Hey Super Scratch crew, well done for getting your first round submission videos in. Love what I'm seeing, you're all doing great. I just thought I'd make you a quick video just to help you take the next step. So really, a lot of you have got the basics down where over a beat you've kind of got these straight timed clean transform sounds which sound something like this. Let's see. So that's awesome. What I was going to show you is really the next step from there is to move from those kind of standard timings to something more expressive. And so here's one technique that you can play with. It's like three clicks. Let's see. So with a beat. Just a little something you can throw in to break up this kind of straight timing. The other thing I was going to say to you was, so there's kind of like when you start off, and I think even in the video, I kind of tap my thumb. But as you get kind of more into it, I've noticed, at least for myself, that I tend to use, like, my hand goes from doing this, where everything's in the thumb, or if you're a regular, I'm guessing it would be like tapping, to being more like my wrist is upright, and the movement comes more, you can't really see, I'm trying to hold this. From the wrist, the pivot. So my thumb doesn't have to do all the like fast work. It's still tapping, but the main like pivoting is coming. You can see it's like this way. That's regular. So this way, so just to be aware of that and play with it. And then really what I'd love you all to do is to move from this kind of straight standard timing where everything's like evenly spaced. To just seeing how expressive you can be. So in my head, when I'm listening, I'm just gonna put the beat on and I'm gonna like scat over the top so you can see how I kind of make up my transform patterns. What I'm hearing when I'm just listening would be like, so it's like, it's not really about the technique, it's about the rhythm that I wanna create based on what I'm feeling from this beat. And you can hear me do. So I'll just end off this video. I'm just gonna do a whole load of freestyling. I haven't practiced transforms for ages, but here we go. Hopefully it'll give you some ideas for patterns. Feel free to copy like what I'm doing as a way to trigger ideas for yourself. Not something to copy and stick with, like this is the way you have to do it, but just to get this rhythm and this kind of flow going, if that makes sense. Okay, let's go. answering. This is a bit too high for me. Threw in a crab there just for good measure. Yeah, so hopefully that gives you something to play with. Let me see what else I have in my notes. Yeah, so to sum up, see if you can move away from doing like very evenly timed transforms. There's that one pattern, da 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 da. I don't know if you noticed then, but I tend to keep my hand on the record and just kind of let that go backwards and forwards in time with the beat, and then it's really the fader that's changing up the rhythm. And then play around with, if you're tapping using your thumb or fingers, see about moving the pivot point to your wrist and see what effect that has. I look forward to seeing your videos at the end of the month. Peace.